Also, who are you? I don't know what the sound was, but hi you guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, you'll have Kanksha. So in today's video, we are going to try a bunch of new makeup. Yay! So I'm very excited about this video. I'm literally very, very excited because a lot of products, I mean, of course, are amazing. That's the reason I'm very like, you know, keen to try them. I've bought like some beautiful products which I've heard so much about, so I'm so excited to try, and I've received them like 2 weeks ago and I was just like waiting to try them on camera. It was so tempting to just not try them. I was like, I just, you know, have to compile a lot of things so that I can make a video where I'm like, you know, trying different makeup. Will be a fun video to watch. I love it. Like at the end of the day, good day, bad day, like for me personally, just sitting back and watching a good makeup videos makes me like calm. So if you're having a rough day or if you just like, you know, want to calm down, let's just, you know, sit back, grab water. I don't want to say grab snacks because if you're watching 3 o'clock in the night, I don't want you to cheat. So just, you know, grab some water, relax a little bit, light a candle, and let's just, you know, sit and do some makeup. So I do have like different products. Like I have from ColourPop to K Beauty to Fenty Beauty. I have different, like, you know, spectrum of a lot of different things. I have a lot of foreign makeup as well. I know a little, you know, sensitivity going around that. So there's like a mix of products I've bought and the products I've got in PR. So I think I've rambled enough. Let's get started. My brows look a little red. It's because I just tweezed them. They were so damn hairy, like they'll calm down a little bit. Okay, if you see hair follicles on my hair, it's also because I just tweezed and there's a lot of hair on my face which does not want to go, and I don't have the patience to just wash my face because I've already, like, you know, I already did my skincare. Also, if you see a pimple patch, it's because I've, like, you know, been breaking out. Anyways, I'm just talking on and on, huh? Okay, so the first product I have is the Fenty Beauty Skin Tint. I got these products from USA. Like, I've not purchased them locally, like from any Instagram store or anything. My sister stays in US, if you don't know. So, like, if somebody's coming from US, she just asks me, like, if I want something. And if I do, then she sends it. So, I got the Fenty Skin Tint because I'm so much into, like, natural looking base. Especially, like, not natural for the entire face, but for, like, foundation. I've been liking to go with something a little medium or like a skin tint, so I really wanted to try this one. I got the shade 11. Like, I used the website foundation.com and I tried to, like, you know, tweak it here and there and find my shade, and hopefully this will be. I'm a 2310 in foundation, if you're wondering. I hope this shade matches me. I think that's a very decent match, like very, very decent match. So, okay, so on the right side, I'm going to go with the blender full. On the left side, I'm going to use a brush. I'm just going to, like, add a couple of drops. Now, I don't know the coverage of this product, so I'm just going to add that much and blend on this side and see. That's a very decent match. It's a little bit darker, and I hope it does not oxidize because it's going to look very dark. Okay, so one layer and this is my skin. Now, of course, it's a skin tint, so I did not like expect it to like cover my acne or anything. And especially, like, I have new breakouts, so the pigmentation is like a lot more, you know, stronger than normal. So the coverage is like very, very skin-like. The color is okay. Maybe I can go like a shade lighter. I'm just going to try to build it up. So if you layer it, like, the coverage does increase and you know, the blemishes are not so much seen. But I don't know how I feel once I layer it. It feels like it's sitting on my skin, you know, once I layer it. The first layer was fine, but the second layer kind of like looks like it's on the skin. Let me just try with a brush. Maybe it will be different with a brush. For brush, I'm using the Rufa Beauty RB23. I love the finish with the brush a lot more. Like little product only gave me like a lot more coverage. Like one layer of this side is even more than like two layers of this side. It looks very even. This side is so much more cakier, but this side, let me build it up on this side also. So the shade is definitely darker. I'm not sure if you can see it on camera, but definitely it is a tad bit darker and it did oxidize, so it looks a lot more darker. But overall, I like the finish, especially with the brush, the finish is okay. I'm so excited about this. Like, I don't know why I had like a different expectation from this. And I'm not really sure if this is reaching the expectation I had. Then next for concealer, I don't have anything new. So I'm actually using the Maybelline Fit Me, which I've recently started using again. These used to be like my go-to, but for some reason, like once they got over, I never like repurchased. And recently I started using them again. I'm like, why did I ever stop using it? So the next product I have is the Makeup by Mario. For those who don't know who Makeup by Mario is, Makeup by Mario is a very famous makeup artist, especially known, became famous because he does Kim Kardashian's makeup a lot. So his makeup is bomb. Love his looks, love everything he does. So he started his own makeup line and I've been like wanting to try it. One thing I wanted to try, because I've been looking out for a good contour stick lately as well. So he had one, so I got one. This is his contour stick in the shade medium. That shade is beautiful. The shade literally from on my forehead though, can you see that it matches my forehead? Do you like understand what I say when I say my forehead is a lot more deeper than the rest of my face? So that's the reason I just let it be like that, so it naturally looks bronzed. Blend it out like instantly. Oh wow, that shade though, like, so I was contemplating between getting the medium and the next darker shade, because worldwide category I'm usually like a medium tan, and Indian category I'm like a medium. So oftentimes it's like a little confusion when I have to pick shade, like do I come in medium tan, and it's like that. So I first initially thought I'm going to get a shade deeper, but I'm glad I got this, because I think this gives like a more nice natural contour for me. Like the shade, I love that shade. I usually like, you know, contour sticks I'm very picky about because of the shade, and I don't usually like a lot. So damn sis, I love this. Right now my face and my lower jaw is so different in color. Next for blush, I have Rene Lip and Cheek Tint. So this cheek tint I've tried in another shade. I've not tried this shade, it's very new, so I'm going to use this. A lot of products do really, like, you know, sometimes formula is really great, but the shade is not so appealing, and it's like a big turn off because I'm like, I like the product, but that shade is not something I would use. So this shade looked so beautiful and I love the formula, so I wanted to try like one more shade. And let's go ahead. Look at how beautiful that color is. I do have like a link for Rene as well, I think I do. If I do, I'll leave it here. If you want to buy anything from them, I do have a link, like code. What am I saying? None of this is sponsored, by the way. This video is not sponsored by anybody. I'm just doing this because I love my makeup and I know you guys love it too. So let me just do my makeups. Okay, the next one, and I think this is the one I was probably like the most excited to try. I mean, of course, I was excited to try everything, but this also, like, this, because I've heard so many people, like so many makeup artists, so many makeup creators, so many people talk about this product. I always wanted to try it, but it's so expensive, so I never, like, you know, went ahead and bought it. And recently I bought one during the Nykaa sale. Not that I had like any offers on this, but still I went ahead and bought it during that time. So I finally got the Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Finish Powder. So I got the shade Medium Moyen. Why is this thing not opening? Yes. So this is the shade I got. Like, I like my under eye, you know, powder to be a little bright. So I got this mainly for my under eye. I want to see the difference. So one, I am going to use my regular Laura Mercier, and on the other, I want to use the Charlotte Tilbury and see like if powder is worth the hype and worth the money, especially. On the left side, I went ahead and applied Laura Mercier. This powder is for 4,000 and there's no sponge in it. Like, it's not that I would use it, but probably if a powder is 4,000 and it's like you put a good sponge inside, I might use it, you know, like on the go if I want to use this. How? Like, I don't have a sponge inside. That's sad. I do not expect so much to come. That's a lot of powder. That's a lot of powder. Probably should not have done that. So up close, now I do have a little dry under eyes, and Laura Mercier powder is like matte. I know for a fact it's full matte, and I use it because I have oily skin and it helps me prevent the oil for a longer time. So compared to the left eye, which I use Laura Mercier, to the right eye, both look same. Like, the finish of the powder is beautiful, but my left eye does look a little more dry than the right one. And usually when I use Fix Plus, like a setting spray, after I'm done with my makeup, this issue gets resolved, but initially only, like, I can see the finish on the right side is a lot more beautiful and lot less dry, which I really like. But then the brightening effect is not as much as the Laura Mercier, do you see? Because the Laura Mercier is more like a lighter powder and this is a colored powder, and usually when you use colored powder, that is the case. So the next one we have is this K-Beauty Contour and Highlight Pro Palette. This is how it looks. I actually really like the packaging. It feels very luxe, and there are three shades. So they say Highlight, Contour, Pro Palette, but honestly, I don't think this shade is for highlight for me. This will be like a light bronzer. So I don't see this as a highlight palette, but okay, like, I can make it work as a contour. So I'm going to go ahead with like the center shade, and God knows how pigmented it is. So I'm going to go a little light-handed. So the powder is a little red, like a little more warm than what I like. So the Mario one was like a very neutral, very beautiful shade. Like, it's a proper balance of color. It was not too muddy, not too gray, not too warm. But this one is going on a little more warm than what I like, but it's blending out very well. Next for highlighter, I have this Swiss Beauty Highlight and Bronze Palette. So it has three shades, a more like icy one, a gold one, and a more bronzy one. So the first one is what I'm going to use. It's not like icy, it has a subtle hint of gold, but it's not like as much gold as, you know, this one. So I'm going to take my regular brush I use, it's like a normal sheen brush. So this palette is not great. Like, the highlight, I mean, it does reflect on camera. You see, like, you know, there's a little bit of glow, but the way it sits on the skin, it's very like separated, and there's granules of shimmer sitting on it. It's not like a very beautiful creamy type of finish where it's just like glowing evenly. If you look at me, even at from far of a distance, you can see that, you know, there's chunks of like shimmer particles sitting on my skin. It's not like a glow, and even the lightest shade is very goldeny. So the shade is not good, the formula is not good. I don't know why I expected like a very good result from this, and I'm disappointed, and I'm very sad to say that I'm disappointed. Next, I have a brow gel. This is from Anastasia Beverly Hills. I got a mini version to try it out. So this is their brow gel, like in clear. Now I love Fay Beauty's brow brush. Basically it's like a mascara plus a brow gel, but it is a colored one, and sometimes it comes out too strong for me, so I just wanted something which is like, you know, just a normal clear one, and I thought I'll try this one. So let's go ahead and set them brows in place, because I have a lot of hair on my brow, so if I like don't set them, they just like move all around and they are not cute by the end of the day. So like with a colored mascara, like if you don't have a lot of brow hair, maybe like a colored brow gel makes sense. But because I do have like already like very thick brows, when I do go ahead and apply like a colored one, I can't apply as much and set it properly, because I'm always scared that the pigment is going to be too much, and like my brows are going to look very fake and blocked. And with clear, I feel like I'll have the space to work on and set it properly. I think I was right, and I really like this one. It smells so much like it smells straight up like alcohol. So as it's drying down, it's getting hard, which is a good thing. That means it's just drying down, like getting a little hard, so that the hair does not like go in places unless I go in with the oil cleanser and cleanse it off. I did a lot to my face, but my makeup does look subtle, right? Like, doesn't it? I feel it looks subtle. It does not. I don't know. I don't feel like I did like full extreme glam. It's subtle in a way. I don't know. Some people out there might be like, you just applied so much product on your face. What the hell are you talking about? Subtle. Anyways, for eyeshadow palette, I have this new palette which I have. This is from ColourPop. This is their Garden. Garden Variety Palette. It's a beautiful palette, beautiful color, very gardeny, of course. This palette, a page called Deep Beauty Lounge India sent me. Like, it's an Instagram page which sells foreign makeup. So I did shop from them a lot, especially like Skincare Ordinary and all. And I trust them. So if you do want to like buy international makeup, you can from them. This they just sent over to me, like, which is very sweet. And I want to use it today. Pricky Please and Stay Sharp. Like, I'll kind of mix both, because I don't want the transition to be very strong. I want it to be subtle. Not my best look, but I think once we finish everything, it looked decent enough. So next product I want to actually try is this Inglot Duraline. So basically this is a product which you can mix with anything and it'll make it like a waterproof liner type of thing. So I want to, like, you know, scrape off some product from this palette and add a little bit of that Inglot Duraline and see if it acts like a liner. So I think I'm going to go ahead and add like this dark brown, so I can kind of, what do you say, add it as a liner. I don't know how much product to scrape, so I scraped so much. The way they told to use it is just like take the liquid on the back of my hand or on a brush and like just dip the brush in, go on with the eyeshadow. I scraped it out because if it does not work, I don't want it to ruin my eyeshadow palette, okay? So I'm just going to go ahead and take like a drop on the back of my hand. That's actually really nice. This is what I achieved from that eyeshadow. Like, I have like a dark brown liner now. Oh my god, that is really cool. All right, impressed. So I'll just do lashes, mascara, etc. and be back for lips. Okay, so next for lipsticks, I have these Huda Beauty Power Bullet Minis. So these lipsticks, basically Power Bullet, I really wanted to try since a long time because a lot of people rave about it. I always convince myself that I have like so much lipstick already that I don't need to buy. But they came out with like this minis and I was like, I mean, now they're available in minis and I can get two for 1500, then why not? So I have two shades, Girl Strip and Interview. Yeah, that is Girl Strip. I think that's a beautiful nude. Like if I add a little deeper liner, that'll just be beautiful, which I will do in just a second. So this is Interview and this is Girl Strip. So Girl Strip would be like that proper light nude, which will, you know, you can kind of play with a lot. And I think Interview for me would be like a basic normal nude lip. So let me just fix this a little bit with like a liner or something. So yeah, I guess that is the finished look. I actually really like how it turned out. It was a little messy with the eyes, but then I think I do like how it turned out. If you're wondering what lashes I'm wearing, these are the Rufa Beauty Sasha lashes. So I feel my base looks very subtle and very skin-like, although I did everything what I generally do my base, and I think it's because of the skin tint. Right side, I feel it's a little heavy. On the left side, even if I layered a little bit, it's not as heavy, and I like the finish it's giving. And I'm starting to get a little oily already, so I'm not really sure how long this would wear. I would definitely like give you guys an update in my future video. Like this, I'm just like, you know, 50-50 still. I'm not really sure how I feel about the skin tint. I'll have to like kind of use it a little more. Then the next one is the Mario Makeup by Mario stick. This one, love it, love how it blended. Everything looks so subtle, everything blended out really well. I love the color. I'll definitely recommend this, keep on using it. I'm using the shade medium. Then the next one is the Rene Lip and Cheek Tint. This one, the blush, I feel, you know, all these creamy base products, like I've like used a creamy contour, a cream blush, a skin tint, so I kind of feel that's why my base looks really nice. And I think this shade is beautiful. This is the shade Pandora Pink. Beautiful color. I loved how it blended. So the next one we used is the Charlotte Tilbury powder, and I think it is really nice. On the right side, my under eye looks a lot more nicer, and the left side also looks good, but left side looks a little dry than the right one. So I think this did the job without like creasing it. Now I'm very, very picky about my powders. If one thing, like in my entire makeup, I'm picky about, it is powder. I don't like powders usually, especially when it comes to medium skin and deeper skin. You have to be about, you can't use any random powder, because under eye, if you want brightening, you have to use different one. Entire face, you have to use different one. There's like a whole different thing. And I've tried compacts here and there of like colored versions also, but usually they end up being a little heavy. And this one, I feel, kind of set it without it being heavy, but also hydrating it at the same time. And I think I will definitely keep using it, because of course I have it. But you don't have to, like, you know, invest 4,000 in a powder if you don't have that. K-Beauty, Sugar, all these are really good, affordable drugstore colored powders, so you can try those as well. So the next one, this one, the Swiss Beauty highlighter. I actually had high hopes for this, but did not turn out good at all. They have a rounded one, which I actually like. That's the reason I got this, that maybe this will also be nice. But this disappointed me. I don't like it. It's like a chunky shimmer, which is there on my skin. Does not give me like that very glowy effect. It's just like a typical chunky highlighter, which I'm not usually a fan of. Next we have the Anastasia Beverly Brow Gel. Clear brow gel, decent enough, like it, will keep using it. So the next one we have is the ColourPop Garden Variety Palette. I think the palette is beautiful, the colors are beautiful, pigmentation is good, blending is good, shimmers are good, mattes are also good, and I'm really impressed by the palette. And I think if you want to, like, you know, invest in this, like, usually I would not like ask you to invest in palettes, but this is such a beautiful, like, layout, I mean, this side is like neutral, I can use any type. But if you want to be a little more fun, you can play around with purple, a little more warm shades. And I think it's a very, you know, cute palette to use, like versatile palette to use, basically. We have the Inglot one. This though, I will recommend it to you guys, especially if you're somebody who's in the makeup field and you like do a lot of different looks and you don't want to like buy different color eyeliner every single time. Just get this one palette, which you have colors, you'll get liner, eyeshadow, you'll get everything in it, and it's just like 700, I think, and 700 can get you like literally 700 different looks. So the next Huda Beauty ones, decent lipsticks, like, you know, everyday matte creamy lipsticks, nothing like very great about it. Of course the shades are unique, but you know, a Makeup Revolution, this one, or the K-Beauty matte lipstick, these also kind of give me the same finish. And if you can find a shade you like, I don't think you'll have to like invest so much. But yeah, they are beautiful lipsticks. And of course, if you want to invest, you want to gift yourself, you can always gift yourself. So the next one I have is this K-Beauty highlighter, contour and highlighter palette. I do like it. I feel the shades are a little more warm, and also I used a contour stick today as well, and then I put this on top, so kind of I do feel like that also made a little difference of how warm it's looking. But I think I really like it. I love the way it blended. I love the way it's sitting on the skin. Nothing patchy, nothing weird. Just blended into the skin very, very easily and very beautifully. This also gets a thumbs up from me. I hope you enjoyed the video. And if you did, then make sure like and subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.